What's up, internet? It's Talia. So here I am today attempting to make a headband wig, and I just thought I would record the process and show you all how it turned out in the end. So I actually started out making a separate first headband wig with a different tactic, and this actually would have worked a lot better if I hadn't messed it up in the end, which you'll see later. But essentially what I did on the first one was sew an elastic band around the circumference of a wig cap inside out so that I could flip it the other direction and then have it fit more securely and just have the elastic band more secure on the inside. This was my fault completely, but you'll see at the end of all this sewing, I was cutting the excess lace, if you will, but it was just the wig cap, away from the elastic band, and I was really dumb and accidentally like cut straight into the middle of the wig cap and like ruined it. So I had to start over, which you'll see in a few seconds. And it's also to be noted, I know you guys see me sewing on this foam wig head that I've had forever, and yeah, I would not recommend doing this. I just don't have a like cloth wig head in my size. I'm like a 22 circumference head, but I have a lot of hair, so I usually get a 23, and this is a 21 diameter wig head. So I just used it so that, I don't know, I just used it because it's old, but in case I mess it up with the glue, if you saw, I'll use later. But yeah, I would not recommend you use a foam wig head. I just use what I had. This is where I mess up the cutting thing and start over, so just enjoy watching me fail, I guess. So here I am back with a fresh, brand new wig cap, and so what I decided to do this time was take two T-pins and just glue the elastic band to the back of where the wig would be, inside out again, of course, just to give it some stretch and hold it on without having lace at the front. I actually wanted to make a frontal wig at first, but the whole reason why I decided to make a wig randomly anyway is because I got the bundles really cheap. My favorite beauty supply store, like, he was having a sale on the bundles just because he didn't have a matching frontal for the color I chose, which was a 33, so it's kind of like a deep red color. So I went to another beauty supply store and they didn't have this brand or this color either. The closest they had was a 30, which is a much like more vibrant red. So I just decided to make a headband wig instead. And yeah, so right now what I'm doing is just measuring all of the wefts and then just gluing them down and then taking a blow dryer and then just trying to solidify the glue like that. And I'll just keep doing that until I get to the center of the wig cap where it kind of gets a little bit loose, and then I'll start going diagonally. You can see here that my angle of my camera changed, and that's just because I had a conference call I had to hop on, so I just kind of came back to finish after that. So I should also add that I would recommend using a marker or a Sharpie of some sort to mark out the lines where you're going to place the wefts before you do this. I just don't follow instructions and felt like freehanding, which is why some of these wefts look crooked and really gross. Not that it really matters because you're not going to see those, but that's why they look like that. So at this point, I finished using one whole bundle, and so I'm moving on to a second bundle. I originally bought three. I got them in a 10, 12, and 14 inch, but I only ended up using the 12 and 14. The 14 at the bottom was the one I just finished, and then I'm going in with the 12 now. So at this point, I'm at the center of the wig where it kind of puckers up a little bit. And so instead of going around the whole circumference of the head with the wefts, I'm just doing the filling in the center, as you can see, so that it'll look more natural. Since it is a headband wig, it doesn't need a part or anything. And yeah, so that's what I'm doing now. I decided that I had enough hair and I didn't want to open up the third bundle. Like I said, the wig cap is placed so far down because this head is smaller than my actual head, so I kind of just left all that knowing that that's what I would need for my actual hair, which I could cut off later when I was done. So this is just me tying the scarf around it, and this is what it looked like at the end.